Today in the news, Intel thinks we're in 2035, g.skill shows off some fast RAM, and InWin goes full RGB. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, let me just give a big thanks to our sponsor, Memory Express. They're based here in Canada and offer a complete price beat guarantee, not to mention their stores, which are a great place to try out all of the newest peripherals before you buy them. Check out their online shop in the link down below. Alright, so we all know that Intel is ramping up their GPU game to try and jump into the discrete graphics market by 2020. Well, during Computex, they decided to show off a bit with concepts of their Xe GPUs. The only thing is these concepts are for the year 2035. Yep. So these renders actually look pretty cool, with some of them having some pretty weird traits. You have the Prometheus Concept that has a few OLED screens and looks like something right out of Corsair's handbook. This concept is probably something that could be done today, honestly. The Oblivion, on the other hand, looks like something straight out of a steampunk machine with rusty gears and... is that a rusty PCIe connector? How is that gonna work? Next up is the Gemini, which looks like the Oblivion without the steampunk vibe. It also looks like it might need some help in the cooling department. After that, we have the Andromeda, which, I mean, let's be honest, is this even a GPU? It kind of looks like a translucent OG Xbox that's been squished to the size of a GPU. And lastly, but definitely not least, the Sirius is a concept card with a PCIe connector on the top. Or is it the bracket that's upside down? Anyways, they all look pretty cool, but I mean, why Intel? Most of these just look like mods that could be done on current GPUs with enough money and free time. We didn't even get an update on the actual Xe platform for desktops. But I'm still curious, what about you guys? Any of the concepts you saw look appealing to you? Let me know which one of yours is your favorite down below. Moving on, we've got g.skill with some pretty extreme showcase of DDR4 memory. One of their demos featured an Intel Xeon W processors with 12 slots of memory, all filled with 32 gigabyte sticks at 4000 megahertz. That's a whopping 384 gigabytes of memory fitted into an ROG Dominus Extreme motherboard. I mean, the more RAM the better, but this is getting excessive. They also had the highest frequency memory kit running at the whole Computex show. It was on an Intel Z390 board with a 9700KF, and the kit of dual channel Trident Z Royale was running at 5200 MHz with a cast latency of 18. On the AMD side of things, they were running some 3600 and some 4000 MHz memory kits on the X570 chipset, but they were all equipped with 2nd gen Ryzen processors, so it's understandable. Personally, I really want to see how far memory can be pushed on X570 with a 3rd gen Ryzen CPU. I guess we'll have to wait until July for that, or maybe until E3. Speaking of AMD, it looks like PCIe 4.0 is definitely going to be short-lived. To give you a bit of background, PCIe Gen 3 received its base specification back in 2010. We then saw the first motherboard with the technology in 2011. For PCIe Gen 4, the base specs were published back in late 2017, with the first motherboards coming in this year with the X570 platform. Well, yesterday, the PCIe Gen 5 base specification have been published, so I guess we're only 2 to 3 years away from seeing motherboards with the new specs pop up. It's not that big of a deal given the continuous backwards compatibility of the technology though. On the other end, we now know that AMD doesn't intend to sit on PCIe Gen 4 like Intel will most likely do with Gen 3. Jerry Talbot from AMD said that they look forward to meeting the future bandwidth demands of end users with PCIe Gen 5 technology. How long do you think PCIe Gen 4 will last? Let me know down below. Moving on, we have InWin with some concept cases. The Alice concept was apparently created because customers and gamers asked for a lighter case for easy transport, either within the house or to LAN parties. As you can see, it's made of 100% pure ABS. Yep, a plastic computer case. Well, it's not all plastic since the exterior is actually wrapped in some cloth. To me, it still doesn't look that great. Kind of like a lampshade, but to each their own. InWin says that if this goes to market, they could sell it for as little as $40, which is pretty cheap for a computer case, but pretty expensive for a lampshade. They also had the InWin 309, a tempered glass case with 144 blocks of addressable RGB on the front panel. The case is based on the 307, except for the front panel, of course, and it will come with three RGB fans with addressable RGBs too. All this addressable RGB business will make the case around $200 to $225 USD. I mean, I like RGB, but I think this is a little much for me. Anyways, guys, that is pretty much it for today's stories. Hopefully you've enjoyed. If you have any questions, put them down below. And don't forget to leave a like if you liked it. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, my dude, and I'll see you on the next one.